Section 1 of On the Preparations of the Indian Hemp or Gunjah. Section 1. On the Preparations of the Indian Hemp or Gunjah, Cannabis Indica, their effects on the animal system in health, and their utility in the treatment of tetanus and other convulsive diseases. By W.B. O'Shaughnessy, M.D., Bengal Army, late Professor of Chemistry and Materia Medica in the Medical College of Calcutta. London. Printed by S. Taylor, 6 Chandos Street, Strand. Reprinted from the Transactions of the Medical Society of Calcutta, 1838, and from the Provincial Medical Journal, 1843. Indian Hemp, and so on. The narcotic effects of hemp are popularly known in the south of Africa, South America, Turkey, Egypt, Asia Minor, India, and the adjacent territories of the Malays, Burmese, and Siamese. In all these countries, hemp is used in various forms by the dissipated and depraved as the ready agent of a pleasing intoxication. In the popular medicine of these nations, we find it extensively employed for a multitude of affections, especially for those in which spasm or neuralgic pain are the prominent symptoms. But in Western Europe, its use, either as a stimulant or as a remedy, is equally unknown. With the exception of the trial as a frolic of the Egyptian hashish by a few youths in Marseille, and of the clinical use of the wine of hemp by Hahnemann, as shown in a subsequent extract, I have been unable to trace any notice of the employment of this drug in Europe. Much difference of opinion exists on the question whether the hemp so abundant in Europe, even in high northern latitudes, is identical in specific characters with the hemp of Asia Minor and India. The extraordinary symptoms produced by the latter depend on a resinous secretion with which it abounds, and which seems totally absent in the European kind. The closest physical resemblance, or even identity, exists between both plants. Difference of climate seems to me more than sufficient to account for the absence of the resinous secretion and consequent want of narcotic power in that indigenous in colder countries. In the subsequent article I first endeavour to present an adequate view of what has been recorded of the early history, the popular uses, and employment in medicine of this powerful and valuable substance. I then proceed to notice several experiments which I have instituted on animals, with the view to ascertain its effects on the healthy system. And lastly, I submit an abstract of the clinical trials of the treatment of several patients afflicted with hydrophobia, tetanus, and other convulsive disorders, in which a preparation of hemp was employed with results which seemed to me to warrant our anticipating, from its more extensive and impartial use, no inconsiderable addition to the resources of the physician. In the historical and statistical department of the subject, I owe my cordial thanks for most valuable assistance to the distinguished traveller, the Syed Keramat Ali, Mutawali of the Hooghly Imambara, and also to the Hakim Mirza Abdul Raziz of Tehran, who have furnished me with interesting details regarding the consumption of hemp in Kandahar, Kabul, and the countries between the Indus and Herat. The Pandit Mudusadun Gutu has favoured me with notices of the statements regarding hemp in the early Sanskrit authors on Materia Medica. To the celebrated Kamalakantha Vidyalanka, the Pandit of the Asiatic Society, I have also to record my acknowledgements. Mr. Da Costa has obligingly supplied me with copious notes from the Muxun ul Udwiye and other Persian and Hindi systems of Materia Medica, for information relative to the varieties of the drug and its consumption in Bengal. Mr. McCann, the Deputy Superintendent of Police, deserves my thanks. And lastly, to the medical gentleman named in the sequel, I feel much indebted for the clinical details with which they have enriched the subject. Botanical characters, chemical properties, production. Botanical description. Assuming, with Lindley and other eminent writers, that the cannabis sativa and indica are identical, we find that the plant is dioecious, annual, about 3 feet high, covered over with a fine pubescence, The stem is erect, branched, bright green, angular. Leaves alternate or opposite on long, weak petioles. Digitate, scabrous, with linear, lanceolate, sharply serrated leaflets, tapering into a long, smooth, entire point. Stipules, subulate, clusters of flowers axillary, with subulate bracts. Males lax and drooping, branched and leafless at base. Females, erect, simple and leafy at the base. Calyx, downy, five-parted, imbricated. Stamens, five. Anthers, large and pendulous. Calyx covered with brown glands. Ovary, roundish, with pendulous ovule, and two long filiform glandular stigmas. Achenium, ovate, one-seeded. Vide Lindley's Flora Medica, page 299. The fibres of the stem are long and extremely tenacious, so as to afford the best tissue for cordage, thus constituting the material for one of the most important branches of European manufactures. The seed is simply albuminous and oily, and is devoid of all narcotic properties. Chemical properties. In certain seasons and in warm countries, a resinous juice exudes and concretes on the leaves, slender stems and flowers. The mode of removing this juice will be subsequently detailed. Separated and in masses, it constitutes the churros of Nepal and Hindustan, and to this the type or basis of all the hemp preparations are the powers of these drugs attributable. Footnote: for very fine specimens of churros, I have to express my thanks to Dr. Campbell, late political resident at Nepal. End footnote. The resin of the hemp is soluble in alcohol and ether, partially soluble in alkaline, insoluble in acid solutions. When pure, of a blackish grey colour, hard at 90 degrees, softens at higher temperatures and fuses readily. Soluble in the fixed and in several volatile oils. Its odour is fragrant and narcotic, taste slightly warm, bitterish and acrid. The dried hemp plant, which has flowered, and from which the resin has not been removed, is called Gunjah. It sells for 1 shilling and 6 pence to 2 shillings for £2 in the Calcutta bazaars, and yields to alcohol 20 per 100 of resinous extract, composed of the resin, churros, and green colouring matter, chlorophyll. Distilled with a large quantity of water or spirit, traces of essential oil pass over, and the distilled liquor has the powerful narcotic odour of the plant. The Gunjah is sold for smoking chiefly. The bundles of Gunjah are about 2 feet long and 4 inches in diameter, and contain 24 plants. The colour is dusky green, the odour agreeably narcotic, the whole plant resinous and adhesive to the touch. The larger leaves and capsules, without the stalks, are called bang, subji or siddhi. They are used for making an intoxicating drink, for smoking, and in the conserve or confection termed majun. Bang is cheaper than Gunjah, and though less powerful, is sold at such a low price that for less than a halfpenny, enough can be purchased to intoxicate an experienced person. According to Mr. McCann's notes, the Gunjah consumed in Bengal is chiefly brought from Mirzapur and Ghaziapur, being extensively cultivated near Gwalior and in Tirhut. The natives cut the plant when in flower, allow it to dry for 3 days, and then lay it in bundles.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.